Hey everyone, this is Kirk here again at OptionAlpha.com, where we show you how to make smarter trades. In today's video, I want to go through the quotes and alerts section of the MarketWatch tab here inside of the Thinkorswim platform. It's definitely something that could be helpful to you. I got to tell you guys honestly, we don't use it that often, but I do want to go through it so that you guys know exactly what's there and available. So inside the Thinkorswim platform, again, this is our live platform here. The quotes and alerts section inside of here is housed or kind of lives under this Market Watch tab, something that we kind of briefly covered over in the first introduction video of this course. Now, quotes in and of itself, you can see here, you can just use any current positions that you have. So we can just, you know, tap this and say, okay, here's the actual current positions that we have option by option, you know, line by line. Any of the personal lists that you have, like our Option Alpha list, a public list, you can say like, hey, I just want to look at all ETFs that are out there, right? So the quote thing is just, you know, a really easy way to look at different resources. I think what most people do with quotes is if they have two screens, they might detach this quote. And you can see this is in its own little like floating screen and they use it on two computers. I do not. I only just trade on a single iMac, so it doesn't, you know, really make a difference to me. Inside the alerts tab, this is actually very cool where you can start to set up alerts. Now, I think that the alert functionality in here can be really, really overdone. I have often used alerts for positions that we have for adjustment triggers, which is what we cover in some of the podcasts, and kind of covering how you can use alerts to let you know when an adjustment may need to be happened or may need to happen. But some people use alerts also for the actual underlying stock itself. You can use it in a bunch of different ways. It doesn't really matter. So I'm going to show you how you can use it here a couple different ways, and you can obviously, you know, kind of tailor this to what you want to do. The first one is you can go here and right click on last, which is for the underlying price, and right down here below it says create alert. So what you can do in the actual alert is now create alert on the actual stock itself. So notice that inside the dropdown, this is where you can actually start doing it on vertical spreads, on strangles, straddles, etc. But we're just going to do the actual stock itself. And we're going to say, you know, for whatever reason, once the last price traded is at or below, and in this case, the stock is trading SPY, which is the market is trading for 237. We're going to say, you know what, let us know if it trades below 230, right? And I don't know why, you know, that would be your reason. I'm not, you know, picking that out. It's just, you know, a number. But it's just going to say, look, that's whatever we're going to say. Like, hey, if it trades below 230, then let us know. And this is a great way to disconnect yourself from the markets and not watch and stare at the screen all day. You just set up some alerts if you have, you know, some support levels that you're watching or whatever the case is. And that can help you, you know, stay disconnected and stay mechanical. And once it happens, then it just has a little preview chart. You can say, hey, well, how do you want to get notified, right? Do you want to get notified with a bell? Do you want to send an email, right? If you send an email, then let us know. Do you want to send a text message? If you send a text message, then let us know. Again, this is all set up inside of the original video. So the first video here on kind of how to set this up as far as notifications. But it's very, very easy to use. If you're using the Thinkorswim mobile platform, you can also set up a push notification on your mobile device, which is also very easy. It kind of reduces clutter in your inbox. So again, that's how you can, you know, set up this whole thing. You can also set this up to create a regular alert when this happens. So if this thing reverses and it goes the other way, you can set up alert. You can submit this order in the future. So hey, you know, don't submit this order until this time and this point in the future. So it doesn't really matter, right? So there's a lot of different options in here so that you can actually, you know, set this up. So in this case, I'm going to go ahead and say, you know, send me an email if this happens. And I'm going to say, you know, submit this order right now. No alert for the reverse. Go ahead and create. Now, when this happens, you can see that the alert is now created right in here. So it's definitely at or below. It's not at or below. So it hasn't been triggered yet, right? So the status is active, but it has not been triggered. It hasn't been filled. It doesn't really matter, right? So nothing's going to happen. But now you can see that this is in my alert book. So if I wanted to go in here and change this, then I just right click on this and I could say, I want to replace this with something. I want to just cancel it completely, or I want to create a duplicate alert and put it to something else. I want to change how I'm being notified on this, right? A million different ways that you can go about doing this. So in this case, I'm just going to go ahead and cancel this alert. We don't really need this one. It can, you know, kind of stay in here. And yeah, we're going to just cancel all active alerts. Now, what we can do in the option side of things is a couple things. What I like to do is that when I'm trading a security, let me just move this down so we can kind of see here. Let's say, for example, that I end up selling on SPY in April, which is 46 days out, right in our timeline. Let me just scroll down here for you guys. Let's say I end up selling the 244 call options, okay? And this would actually be something that we could sell, right? The 244 call options have about a 15 delta, which means there's about an 85% chance of success selling those. I could sell them individually as a spread, or I could do it as one side of an iron condor or strangle, whatever the case is. But let's say I sell these options to begin with, and they've got about a 14-15 delta. Well, one of the rules that we use in trading for adjustments is that if the delta doubles, so goes from 15 up to 30, then that might trigger an adjustment in our system. So what I can do is I can set up an alert on this particular strike, just this strike price that I've actually traded, so that if this delta goes from 14 to 30, then I get notified. And this is a great way to actually use these alerts inside Thinkorswim to notify you when you need to possibly make an adjustment. If you don't get notification, then that means everything's good. It's never gone up to 30, which means that the stock really hasn't moved against you, or it hasn't moved against you in any meaningful way between now and expiration. So again, all you want to do here is right click on the actual security, say create an alert, and you want to say, okay, I want to create an alert for just this single option. You can see it's the single spread, the 17 April's, which is 2017, 245 calls. If the delta is at or above at any point in the future, 0.3, let me know, right? That's basically what we want to do. Now, just for full disclosure, if you're doing this on the put side, you do at or below negative 30, right? So puts are always negative delta, so you want to make sure that you're, you know, looking at that the right way. In this case, again, it's going to say, hey, if this delta is any time between, or if this delta ever reaches at or above 30, then let me know. You can also say, I want the last price. If the last price doubles, if the close price is higher, if the mark price is higher, right? Whatever you end up wanting to do, you can end up, you know, basically doing it through this system. Again, all the same email notifications, everything else kind of works the same. And then you go ahead and hit create. Now, in this case, you can see that it's now active, right? So this is now the newest active one in here. The canceled one has already been canceled, and now it's currently working. And again, I've done this many, many times. I do this a lot when I'm not able to kind of monitor a position. So if I'm traveling, or if I'm on vacation, or if I'm in an area where I know I, you know, may not have service to kind of stream quotes on my phone or anything like that, I'll set up these alerts in advance, and then that will let me know via email or text alert or basically mobile push notification if anything is happening in that security, so that we, you know, can get notified of it. So a really, really cool tool, a very useful way to use these alerts. Now, of course, you can get carried away with this. I'm not saying you need these all the time, but it's a great, great resource to have kind of at your disposal. So I'm going to go ahead and cancel these because we don't really need them. Another way that you can set up an alert is with these study alerts. So in the top right-hand corner here, there's a study alert. We have a whole course on how you can set these up and all these codes you can use and just kind of copy in here. So a lot of these are hard-coded in here for different actual think scripts. Is what they're called. So inside of our signals course, that's part of our automated signals blueprint and our technical analysis research, we have these scripts in here that are basically copy and paste. So if you're interested in doing that, check those out. But it basically will then send you a notification to your phone or to your email address or whatever you want if any of the stocks that you follow have a technical study buy or sell signal. This actually ended up happening to me just a couple days ago, and we ended up getting into a short premium trade in one of the ETFs, currency ETFs, because we got a notification that it had a sell signal based on the technical indicators that we set up. So this is a little bit more in depth. Again, I just wanted to, you know, share with you guys how you can do it. You can end up building these out if you want to. There's a lot of additional resources on Thinkorswim's website for this. Probably way too much than I want to get into in this course, but I just want to let you guys know that it is there and it is a possibility. So again, thank you guys so much for checking out this video. Hopefully it was helpful. This is definitely a really cool tool that we use here at Option Alpha. So I would appreciate if you guys would share this video online, help spread the word about what we're trying to do here at Option Alpha. And again, if you have any comments or feedback, just ask them in the comment section right below. Until next time, happy trading.